Hello beautiful people, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Jennifer, Jenny J and D. All right, I welcome you all to my channel once again. Maybe some of you, this will be your first time of watching my videos or seeing this beautiful face. My name is Jennifer and I welcome you all to my talk show today. And as you're going to watch this video, please do not forget to give a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to my channel or you're just coming for the first time, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button under your notification bell so that whenever I post a new video, you will simply be notified. Thank you as you're going to do so. And for my old-time subscribers, thank you for your support. Thank you for always checking back on me. As you're watching this video today, don't forget to share to your friends. Don't forget to drop your contribution down below there in the comment section. Thank you as you're going to do so. May God bless you all. Let's get into the business. Alright guys, today's topic is it sex? It says what we need to keep our mind to ourselves. It says what we need to keep our home in order to make sure that our man is with us, our marriage is cool, everything is cool with us. Because why I bring up this topic today, I've been seeing a lot of posts, a lot of people coming out to say, make sure you satisfy your man so badly in a way that he won't be able to look outside anymore. Make sure you give him any time, any day, any moment, anyhow you want to see it. You know, people preaching about this sex of a thing as if this is one thing, one most important thing we need to do to keep our man to ourselves. So I decided to bring the topic today to my viewers. Let's talk about this. Let's discuss about it. Say, drop whatever it is you think about this topic, your contribution, whatever it is, down below there in the comment section. I will really appreciate it. And the one that really got me was a lady I saw on FB the other day making a live video, you know, telling people that see how sexy she looks, see how young she is after two kids. She's still looking fresh, beautiful, attractive, and all that. That women should try as possible as they can to make sure that they can take care of themselves after childbirth so that they will still look attractive to their men. I think I buy that one. She is right on that one. Secondly, this is the second thing she said. Her first advice was that make sure you satisfy your man, make sure you give your man sex at any given time. That is the only thing that will keep him to you permanently. So I decided to ask this question today. Is she really right on this particular advice that sex is the most important thing you need as a woman to keep your man to yourself? But to tell you the truth, I know sex is very important in a relationship, in a marriage. It's so healthy. It's good. It's very good to, you know, perform that particular duty always. But saying I'm talking out for my own opinion, for my own understanding, how I see it, how I understand it, she is wrong by saying is a very important thing. It's very, very important in the relationship. That is the only thing that you can do to keep your man to yourself. I disagree with her on this one. I disagree with her, yes. So you can also share your own thoughts, share your own opinion with us to hear, because no one is perfect. No one knows it all. But for me, she's wrong. Saying taking care of yourself to look attractive to your man, she's right. But saying sex is the most important thing you need to keep your man to yourself, to keep your marriage healthy, stronger, she's wrong for my own side. So I decided to give a little advice concerning this issue, because these days many women, many girls, they misunderstood this marriage of 18. You see a girl want to get married to a man simply because he has money. So that is the only thing she wants, because she knows that when she enters that marriage, provided the man is not stingy, she will have whatever she wants. She will do whatever she, anything that she need in this life, she can get it. She will be rich as well, you know, things like that. But forgetting the most important thing. From my own understanding, when you marry a man because he has money, there is enough money there. What of tomorrow? Because for me, if I'm doing something, I always think about the positive. I also think of the negative. If that money is no more there tomorrow, when you don't see 50k every month anymore, 100k, 150, 200k anymore, when you don't see a lot of money like before, a lot of goodies from him, when he stopped buying things like that for you simply because business are no more going like before, things are not moving on well, nobody's praying for bad thing, nobody's praying for downfall, but you cannot predict things to happen sometimes. Sometimes we don't pray for what happens, but they do really happen. So what of when things started changing and he starts economizing, he starts less spending? If he used to buy you goodies every now and then, he starts limiting those things because things are not working well anymore. If you are not that kind of understanding woman, what you will do, you start complaining. You start, you know, creating unnecessary problems in your home. And before you know it, tomorrow, you start going to admins to tell them to hide your identity, because the man you are married to has changed. He's no more like he used to be. He's not like this when you were dating him. He's not like that when you first got married to him. He used to be this type of open-handed somebody, but now he's being stingy. But you will not even let this admin to know that things were really better that time, things were really moving on well, but it's no more moving well anymore. You will not say things like that. So what I'm trying to say here is that when you want to get married to anybody, look for the most important, as a woman, as a man. Example, I have a hot temper. You want to get married to me. You make sure that you have so many important things you see in me that is good to you. So in the other hand, you can actually, you know, control the hot temper. You can actually, you know, tolerate me in that part. You, it's something you can bear. It's something you can take. It's something that in you, you believe that with time, you will be able to change it. And you have to know that changing it won't, is not a day something. It won't be a month something. Sometimes it won't even be a 6 months or 1 year something. So this is the things you really have to consider before accepting somebody to live with this person for better for once. Not because he satisfies you well on bed, you jump in because you are how did they say it? Sex addict. So because you think that is all. What of tomorrow? What if anything goes wrong? What if something happened and the daughter have to advise that he used to limit, you know, pounding on bed? What are you going to do? You start seeing him as a weakling. You start looking for another man outside to satisfy you. Yeah, he may be active when you're dating him or when you just newly get married to him. But what of later? What of old age? What of if anything happened that will like cause him not to perform like before? Does it mean that your marriage is going to crash? So you saying that you give your man that the kind of sex he needs, he's satisfying very well, that is the reason why he don't cheat on you. I don't think that is the truth. Maybe he's not a cheater. Because for me, a cheater is a cheater, no matter what you did to these people. No matter what you, if you like, hang your two legs on the ceiling, put your head on the floor, you know, do any kind of style, or more, he will still cheat if he's a cheater. I can remember back in Nigeria where I used to work. There is this a very good custom of ours that he's a humanizer. When they say someone used to cheat, this man is rich, he's tall, he's handsome. But what really got us like thinking, like, this man will have children and wife. So one day we started to ask him because he's so jovial and open, friendly. But we didn't use it because of that one to disrespect him and start asking his stupid question. We really put it in a way that he would understand. And trust me, he understood and he really explained everything to us. He said that all these girls that he used to carry, no one is even half of his wife in the, at home. That when it comes to a woman material, that his wife is number one in any area. So we are like, so what happened? Why are you now carrying girls up and down? Even the last girl he was dating that time, the girl wanted to get married. He was the one that sponsored half of the marriage. He rent an apartment for this girl before this girl now planning on settling down with his her boyfriend. So we were like, ask, so why? He said, when he was in school, he was not like that before. He met this group of friends who they were really together, you know, staying together. They do everything together. They were the ones that introduced him into humanizing, carrying girls. You know, as earlier age that time, this entered into his blood. He started doing it and he don't have any control over it anymore. No matter how his wife do at home, if he see a girl outside, he will still be attracted to them, like to test different girls, things like that. Though it's not that, even sometimes his conscience used to judge him, but he cannot help it. He prays one day God will change him. And I said amen to his prayers. Because you know, woman will be happy seeing that you do everything possible in your home and your man still look outside. But you, some women sometimes coming on social media to deceive people, to talk like things that is not true. It's so annoying to listen to such advice, you telling people that sex is the only thing. It's not the only thing. For my own part, if people ask me, before I settle down with my, I make sure that I find, you see that what they call understanding. That is what I value more. We understand, we connect from each other. No matter how, it's not that we are the best though, that we don't have misunderstandings. No, we do. But we understand each other. When I was living with my parents, I told myself that the kind of marriage my dad and my mom had, the kind of, you know, communication and everything, understanding, that was the kind of marriage I like to have myself. Whereby you have misunderstanding in your home, no matter how critical it is, you settle it yourselves, no ear outside will hear it. So for me, I think understanding is what we should be looking for. You understand each other, you trust each other, you respect each other. Not all. I know so many. I've seen a girl that she's not good in bed. She got married. She today, the guy doesn't cheat on her. Anytime we are talking, she will be like that. She's thanking God the kind of man he gave to her. There is so many men it will be, they will start looking outside. But what the man do is to teach her the things she don't know. Because they understand each other. Because they're meant to be. You know, when they say, look for a life partner, not a money-making machine, not a sex machine. Stop looking for one particular thing to hold, you know, this man is rich. He's the kind of man I like to set so that he will change my world. And you just jump into the marriage. You don't even understand each other. You don't even know if he's the type that tolerates your arrogancy, your misbehavings. And when you enter the marriage now, the money is there for you to enjoy. But you don't have peace of mind. He's not the kind. He's not even friendly. Some people in there, they are not even friendly. Some women, they cannot even talk in their home. This is because they did not look into all these things before settling down. They settled down. You will see some men, they settle down with a woman because of big balls, big ass, and all those things. They didn't even manage to care if she knows how to cook or not. And after marriage, they'll start complaining. After marriage, they are saying that, how can you not know how to cook? A grown-up woman like you, didn't you stay with your parents? Your mother did not go do a good work, blah, 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 blah. And you know about all these things, so you did not bother about it. Because she's beautiful, she's loaded. She's presentable. You know, men, they like it when a woman is presentable. When they take this woman out and their friends will be like, wow, almost it. Girl, man, you are the one that eating this thing. That is all they are after. They are not after any other thing. And at the end of the day, when the deed has been done, when there is no more going back, they will start complaining. They will start fighting in the house. They will start killing themselves. They will start saying everybody will start sleeping on different bed every night. So, it's a very simple advice that I'm here to give. As a woman, as a man, whenever you are ready to settle down, when you are dating somebody, look for the most important things. Check if you can tolerate this person. If you can manage his or her arrogancy. If you can manage her bad mouth, if you can bear it. Or if you are the type that a woman cannot even talk to you, cannot even joke with you, sir, you start raising your hand. There is nothing like when you marry to your best friend, your playmates, that you understand each other, you play with each other. I can even tell my oga, I been come up for here. I can remember those days when I was dating one guy. He cannot even tell him, see this one. With Joko, you cannot tell him that. You say you are assertive. You don't have respect. They don't train you well. I'll be like, Omo, na me and you. I pray, oh, me that I know my mouth very well. There is not like you are talking with your mind. Because I been come up for here, Joe. He can't even come and join. Yeah, you are telling me to go. But all is joke. All is play. Not living with that guy, serious man, very serious. You have to, it's even remaining for you to need as serving food. So in this life, I always say it, even love itself is not enough to build a marriage. So sex is not enough too. Money is not enough too. If you want to settle down, look for a life partner, not a sex machine, not a money making machine, not somebody who can give you millions, but in one day they will beat that millions out of you. Then your eyes will open. Me, I will be here reading your admin, hide my identity. If you like, down here. If you like, don't share to others, even if it does not concern you. Share for people that it concerns. Me, I have said my own. Una bye bye. As I'm going to watch, please. Don't forget to share to your loved one. Share to everybody now. It doesn't cost anything. And if you have not subscribed to my channel, please now. But no, subscribe now. You know how we do it. I want to see your contribution, whatever you have to say, down below there in the comment section. And I will see you again in my next video. Bye-bye for now. Bye.